So Father Mark and I just came back from our community days last week. We did it at the Annunciation of the Lord there in Gloucester, and I was camping out there, and I think right now I'm becoming more known as the homeless priest. I'm just preparing myself that if I misbehave, you know, and then Father Mark said, you can't stay here, I have a place to stay. And in the community days, Father Roger, who's the general superior of the community, gave not a State of Union address, but State of Communion address, you know, because we're talking about our brotherhood. And in that State of Communion address, he really mentioned about the prophecy of Pope Benedict XVI when he was still Father Joseph Ratzinger in 1969. About the future of the church. Ratzinger says there, from the crisis of today, the church of tomorrow will emerge, a church that has lost much. She will become small and will have to start afresh, more or less, from the beginning. She will no longer be able to inhabit many of the edifices she built in prosperity. As the number of her adherents diminishes, so it will lose many of her social privileges. And we see that happening right now more and more. We heard of churches being burned down. We heard about statues being desecrated. You know, in other parts of the world, celebration of the Eucharist is being suppressed. Catholics are going underground. And if they divide a government, they could be put to jail or even put to death. Okay? And this persecution will become stronger and stronger each day. That's why it's here. It says, the church will become small. The church will become small. They're calling it the remnant church. And Joseph Ratzinger also says here in his prophecy that the future of the church, once again, as always, will be reshaped by saints, by men, that is, whose minds probe deeper than the slogans of the day, who see more than others see, because their lives embrace a wider reality. Unselfishness, which makes men free, is attained only through the patience of small daily acts of safe self-denial. By this daily passion, which alone reveals to a man in how many ways he's enslaved by his own ego. By this daily passion, and by it alone, a man's eyes are slowly opened. Okay? It says here, the future of the church, once again, will be reshaped by saints. Okay? And that's why there's a call right now. The call is raising up modern living saints. And we're all called to do that, not just after we die, but as long as we live, we're called to be living saints. And living saints are those who are dying to their selfishness. Okay? And that's why in our first reading today, it talks about the circumcision of the heart. As we know, circumcision is the sign of the covenant that God made with Abraham, wherein all firstborn male Jews, Israelites, need to be circumcised. So there's this physical circumcision, wherein a flesh would need to be taken away. And that also has to do with our heart, the circumcision of the heart. It needs to be removed anything that could enslave us. Anything that goes between us and God, anything that will prohibit us from following His will. Okay? In our first reading today, it says there, in Him also you were circumcised with a spiritual circumcision by putting off the body of the flesh in the circumcision of Christ. When you were buried with Him in baptism, you were also raised with Him through faith in the power of God, who raised Him from the dead. And when you were dead in trespasses and the uncircumcision of your flesh, God made you alive together with him when he forgave us all our trespasses. The wages of sin is death. Okay? And we come back to life whenever we repent, when we ask for forgiveness. Okay? So that's what we're called to do. We always need to examine our heart. Is there things there that we need to circumcise, that we need to let go of? Okay? And the most important thing that we need to let go of is selfishness. Selfishness is the root of all sin, as well as pride. We need to let go of that so that we will become living saints that will shape the future of this remnant church.